This is a past, present, future spread for one of my clients. This is not a three-card spread for me. I draw three cards for each position or aspect of this reading. I'm curious. I really want an in-depth look at you and your life and what it all entails and how it's made you who you are today. And I also like to know where you're going from this point forward. Like I said, I'm curious, so this is not just a three-card reading for me. Now, the following reading was done for a young woman who's just starting out with a new situation in her life and plenty of decisions to make for the future, and we're going to call her Liddy. I use the Tarot Illuminati deck, by the way. The first set of cards for the past, Eight of Pentacles, Six of Pentacles, and Temperance. She was instilled with a strong work ethic. She's also spent a great deal of time, money, and effort on learning a skill, getting a degree, absorbing knowledge and experience to help her on a terrific work employment path. There is a sense of intense focus and the ability to take things seriously when the need is there. Also, a good sense of concentration and determination. The past saw Liddy comfortable with her financial situation, comfortable with her friends and family, outgoing, and basically happy. However, with that said, there's also the impression that with a much younger Liddy, there was a central male figure who generously helped her out, took care of her financially, and probably in a variety of other ways as well. But with this comes a price, and that price might have been personal freedom. Freedom of thought, freedom of choice on a variety of personal levels, and freedom to openly explore the world on all levels. There is a sense of restriction with this male figure, perhaps a sense of dogged stubbornness as well, an inability to compromise, a suffocating feeling of conventionality. Angels follow Liddy, as well as spirit guides she may not realize are there, or guides she does not have the spiritual liberation, knowledge, or experience to recognize. Among these guides may be the spirit of a loved one who has passed and who is very close to Liddy, and this spirit maintains this closeness in spite of Liddy's seemingly oblivious nature. Liddy may feel this presence, though she doesn't acknowledge it to those around her, and she might not even acknowledge it to herself, but it's there. Okay, the present for Liddy. The cards are the Empress, the Alchemist, and the Emperor. Oh gosh, Liddy's life is basically influenced by three people dominating her life at this point. There is the feeling that the bright and studious individual who is immersed in the Eight of Pentacles, the scholar, the girl with dreams and goals, is lost. I feel that Liddy is in a situation now, even if she doesn't recognize it yet, where she will lose her own sense of self, her own identity, and with it, the ability to think for herself and make her own decisions. Liddy may view these people as authority figures. Liddy may respect and love them. And trust their decisions and their decisions for her as well. All kinds of warning signs go up for me with these three cards together. They create a daunting and intimidating line of authority. If Liddy heard a door slam, you can be sure that it was the door on her gilded cage. If Liddy is comfortable and compliant now, all will be well, but this will not last. One day, an older Liddy may suddenly wake up to the circumstances surrounding her, and if she ever chooses to challenge the authority figures regulating her life, it could have devastating and liberating results. Okay, we're going to move on to the future. The cards for this aspect are Ten of Cups reversed, The Fool and the Moon. There is the impression of a happy family, a couple, and children turned upside down. either by someone's choices and decisions or by something totally unexpected and beyond their control. There's also the idea that in the future, Liddy's dreams will come full circle. She may suddenly decide to take up where she left off on her journey towards study and apprenticeship, personal goals, and dreams. Though this existence will be different from the way it started out, from the way Liddy expected it to stay, that doesn't mean that it won't be colorful and joyful, that it won't be filled with promise and a bright existence. It will just be different, not the way Liddy thought it would be. She probably doesn't see this coming at this point in her life. She's so sure that her future is set, her plans are laid in concrete. And we all do this, and just when we get comfortable or resigned to our life and the way things are, the universe throws a wrench in our plans. In this new phase of Liddy's life, she's going to have to come to terms with some truths and some falsehoods. This may imply that someone has not been completely truthful with her, but that Liddy may not be completely truthful with herself as well. The moon is full of deception and shadows, casting questions and doubts on her sense of reality, her memories, and the motives of those who've been closest to her in these early adult years. Liddy is going to find the future liberating in a variety of ways, and much of this liberation will come when she learns to recognize and acknowledge truth.